is basically a fear of movement. This can be present in people who have injured themselves, and then whenever they go back into a sport, they are afraid of moving too fast or putting too much stress. This is also very common in people who have operations or surgeries that they also have to go back and then start playing again. And a lot of times they don't feel like they are able to compete at the same level than they had prior to the injury or surgery.
What is kinesophobia? Kinesophobia is actually a fancy word just for a patient's sense of being afraid of moving. We know that actually kinesophobia, or fear of movement, actually can increase your pain. We really see that there's typically two types of people. One group of people are afraid to move, so they use prolonged periods of rest as a way in which to treat their pain. The other group of people tend to power through it and believe that no matter what they do, they can just deal with the pain and move forward. Kinesophobia is that first group of patients, or that fear of movement group. And what we really know now is that not moving is one of the worst things that we can do for chronic pain. We know that bed rest for longer than 3 days actually significantly increases your risk of developing chronic pain from an acute pain episode, such as back strain after you've worked out in the yard or participated in some other type of activity. We know that movement is extremely important, both in the acute and subacute phases of pain, but also in chronic pain. So many of the therapies that we do are really meant to help get you moving back to normal once again, bending, twisting, lifting, doing all those types of things. And we can do that using many different types of techniques. Again, appropriate non-addictive medications, minimally invasive injections, physical and occupational therapy, supervising you with some specific home exercises that you can do, acupuncture, some types of supplements often can be helpful. And there are a number of things we can help you with, again, with that process of moving through the pain.
And so there's a scale, it's called a TAMPA scale of kinesiophobia, or TSK. It was created back in 1990 for low back pain, chronic low back pain. It's basically a questionnaire, 17-item questionnaire that's subjective. And so the real thing is with kinesiophobia, it's a very subjective thing for the athlete, and so that plays a big role.
Okay, so we looked at some research to see how the psychological effect of kinesophobia can really affect somebody's likelihood to return and play. And so we found several studies, and this particular one, about half of the patients that they studied did not return and play because they didn't feel confident in their abilities, and they didn't feel like they used the TSK and a couple other questionnaires just to see that they truly didn't feel confident in their body's abilities.
And this was another one done with pre-operative patients. So basically they used the same scale again, and kinesiophobia was higher in patients with chronic cervical pain, and this was for not only upper, like neck and stuff, but also low back pain. And it was also found, not only this study, but a couple others said that the fear of movement tended to be higher in women, although we did found another one that stated the opposite, that it was guys that were more, that had greater fear. However, with that study, they also said that there was other outlying factors such as psychological disorders and such that proved that.
Okay, so basically this issue is pretty big. If it's a 50% of patients who, they go through the same rehab, but half of them don't feel confident enough to return and play, then there needs to be something that we can do to help rehab them psychologically too while we're rehabbing their body. And so and showing them that they can have those abilities to do those activities that are sport specific and that their body can